www.joymoore.org. Coming up next, it's about health with our host, Joy Moore. Please stay with us. Good afternoon. This is About Health. This is Joy Moore. I want to see if we can get this sound together here. Dr. Lenore will be back next week, but he's giving us the space today, and we got some space today. We are celebrating the birth of Malcolm X and Martin Luther King and Barack Obama all at one time. And all the ancestors that paved the way for us today. We're just expanding it. We're going to do a great show today. We're going to honor our ancestors, as always. You know, on MLK Day, we try to give space for people to call in and give shout-outs for people they miss and love. And we're honored also to be joined in the studio by some community advocate activists, entrepreneurs that are out there making good news. So this is a good news show today, too. We're going to talk about good news. And you guys can all call in and join us, you know. We'll be taking calls in the second half an hour, but right now, sit back for a minute, make a phone call, get somebody else to join us. Stay tuned. We got an hour. Good news. Honoring our ancestors. This is About Health. Right, you are with About Health today. This is Joy Moore filling in for Dr. Lenore. And today we're going to talk about honoring our ancestors today, start out with. And in fact, it's all about building community and how important community is and what do we talk about, what do we mean when we say community. So I want to start with our ancestors because without them there would be nothing, and we have to honor them and understand and respect and appreciate that we too will be ancestors one day. So it's very important. It's full circle. It's holistic. You know, I'm into the holistic. So I'm really excited. I want to start out by giving a shout out. I'm going to invite people to call in and give shout outs later in the hour. But right now I want to give out a shout out to my family. Half of my family, they're gathered around the computer in Washington, D.C., taking part of the Obama History Adventure Spectaculation going on. My sister Kathy, my sister-in-law Lola, my aunt Kay, my brother David, my cousins Lisa and Michael, and my niece Courtney and Kennedy. I don't know who else is there, but everybody else too. I want to shout out. I hope you're listening to us. You said you would. If you didn't, you're making me look bad. And if you meet or see or get close enough to see Obama, give him my love, all of our love, and strength, because he's going to need it. And thank y'all for representing out there in Washington in the 30-degree weather. Kind of cold, snowy, too. All right, so we're going to get all that out of the way. Shout out to my family. And I want to talk about ancestors, that my ancestors woke me up today with a phone call from David Roach, actually. They used David Roach to wake me up this morning. David Roach is one of the guests we have here today from Mo Better Foods. We also have Anne-Marie Carter, the seed lady from Watts. And we have, say, I hope I get it right, I just met the brother today, Yafeo.
Tayemba.
Tayemba from Culture Freedom. And we also have Michael Flynn from Common Vision. And man, today we got a, some of us were out at Castlemont High rejuvenating and replanting and reclaiming a wild garden at Castlemont High. It was about 50 people out there, working hard together. And then these guys got so much energy, they went to the tree plant at MLK and they hooked up with Michael Flynn from, Common Vision. And everywhere we went today, we saw people, you know, doing something, hanging out outside, you know, planting trees and talking and sharing themselves with each other. So welcome all of you.
Thank you so much
for coming in here today. Just keeping the party going, because we've really been on a high, haven't we?
Yes, sir.
So this is the kind of thing that should happen all the time. I'm very happy to be involved and proud of this. But I want to start out by asking my guests, all of them, about the good news of what they're doing. We're going to start with Anne-Marie and work our way around. You know, this is the thing that we miss the most in our culture, the time to celebrate what's good.
That's right.
And we need more of that. So today, we're going to take that space. We're going to invite you guys to call, and I'll give you a number in a minute. But right now, let's just start with Anne-Marie. Tell me what the good news is out there and what should we all know about what's going on and how we can be helping you with it. Anne-Marie Carter, Seed Lady from Watts.
Oh, I'm so thankful that you allow me to be on your program today, Joy. It is a blessing for me to be here with you and to see you once again and to sit down on the side of a garden plot and plant collard greens and Swiss chard and all types of different little fresh organic veggies today. That was a beautiful ceremony we did honoring our ancestors and all of those people that are moving and shaking this earth at this time. I really want to let everybody know that the Seed Lady of Watts has some good news for everybody on the entire planet. I have been blessed. I have 9 products. I started this month to let everyone know about all my organic products, but then all of a sudden one of my sponsors came and dropped a product in my lap and said, here, check this out. And what it is, it's an organic product that has been, it's a new technology using thermogenics. And what they do is they take an organic substance and they fire it up over 1,000 degrees and they change its metabolic structure so that it has the ability now to absorb carbon. Okay. As you all know,
the CO2 stuff that we're scared of.
The CO2, okay. It has the ability to absorb carbon from our atmosphere.
From the air.
From the air.
Wow.
And I'm so excited about it. I had to fly up here just to be with you guys to let you know it's on now. It is on. I'm taking the gloves off.
Okay.
And it is on because I am on my way to see our beloved governor. And after I leave him, I'm going to see our new beloved president.
Okay.
And I'm going to lay this technology on their desk and I'm going to say, here it is. This is one of the solutions, and I consider myself to be a solutionary. I spell
a
that.
Solutionary.
S-
Can we get that? Hold it. Solutionary.
U-L. Not okay. S-O-L-U, but
okay.
S-O-U-L. And I'm going to take it to them, and we're going to see if we can't get them to distribute it widely to start getting rid of some of the CO2 on our planet.
Excellent. Oh, my God. Look, this woman is saving the planet
right now,
as we all are. We all are. Let's go on to... Yafeo. I'm going to get it right.
Yafeo.
I met today out at Castlemont. Man, oh, man, it was a beautiful thing.
Oh, yes.
It was a beautiful thing to see people come together and work hard together and make something beautiful. I mean, what was there was beautiful. Don't get me wrong. It was a wild garden that had been neglected. But you could see there was love there in the past, and we brought some more love to it and fixed it up.
Yes,
and this brother helped us out. Tell us about what you bought that's good news today.
Well, I have a trivia game because my mother just showed me the intelligence report and they were doing this link between the high schools and the prison.
Mm.
And my game was inspired by that same energy. I had worked in the inner cities of McClymonds High School in Oakland, California, West Oakland, California for 5 years. And I had saw the impact that music had on the community. I had kids that I had spent thousands of hours with in the gym, mentoring and loving and just being a part of the community. They would say a rap verse and they would be dead. Or they'd be in the penitentiary. And
really?
Me and my brother David here, we just saw one of our pregnant ex-students and her husband had just got 10 years. So, you know, this is something that's currently affecting us. So, you know, I had a dream. I needed to make something happen. So I created a trivia game, a geopolitical trivia game with all African American as well as Africans from the diaspora answers. And basically it's called Black Like Me, mm-hmm. to kind of combat this whole genocide with hip hop that I
right.
see going on, you know,
right.
the nonsense in the music. And from that standpoint, it builds esteem, it builds community. And it's something that I like to share. I have two more editions coming out this year.
Mm-hmm.
I have one that's currently in Marcus Bookstore, you know,
right.
or you can get it online, culturefreedom.com.
Okay.
That's culture with
good.
A K.
Good.
And basically, that's my mission. Culture Freedom mm-hmm. is working with marginalized communities in every aspect. We have people. We're doing recovery groups at Glide Memorial Church. We're doing domestic violence groups at the City of Refuge in San Francisco, as well as I have a couple of personal cases. I work with my mother, as well as a former Golden State Warrior player, Cedric Washington. So, you know, I'm just expanding my horizons and trying to keep moving. I also work in tandem with my brother over there, David Roach.
Okay. So this is the entrepreneurial part I was talking about. We're all entrepreneurs here. It's not just about social justice. It is about social justice, but
yes.
beginning with us as well,
right?
So let's go to, thank you for that. And I saw those cards that you were talking about. I love the idea of bringing back things that we already know. First of all, there's nothing new under the sun. I heard that today. Anne-Marie Carter reminded me that. We must remember, there is nothing new under the sun. We reform it, we reconfigure it, we call it something else, but everything here has been here pretty much from the beginning. We may discover it anew, and that's different. But the same thing about these facts, information, the foundation of a people is their history and their accomplishments and their culture, their songs, their innovation, their religion, their spirituality, how they build their house, how they raise their kids. Those things, those are the foundation of a people, and that's the one thing that the American African diaspora is missing, that we haven't found a way to go back and get our history and reclaim it to sturdy that foundation. And this brother's game does that. If you saw some of the questions, it was really exciting. To have that, because we do love card games. And unfortunately, or fortunately, depending on how you look at it, in prison, card games are a big deal. Just think about it. Card games are a big deal in prison, and they remain a big deal in the African culture, you know, as a pastime. So what better way than to have some information actually going into your head while you're playing cards?
I love it.
It's a small, beautiful thing that is what all big, complicated things are made of. Small little things. Everything complex is made of a little, small little thing, a whole bunch of them, top of another. So we get at it with a shovel in the garden, or with a deck of cards, or with, you got to tell me again, the...
Thermogenic.
Pulling CO2 out of the air.
Yes.
We're going to go next to David Roach, who really roped me into this this energy-filled work day celebrating Obama and his call for action today, which we always did. David and I always used Martin Luther King Day, and Anne-Marie, I know for sure, we've always used Martin Luther King Day to work to further the cause. It wasn't about staying in the bed dreaming all day.
That's right.
What he meant, it was a metaphor, and people took it the wrong way. Like, we're going to stay home from work and lay in the bed and dream, but it's not that. It's about getting out and accomplishing something. And we did today. We made a beautiful garden.
Oh,
talk
wow.
about it, David. How'd you get us all in there?
Wow. You know, what's good is being here with you and everyone in this room and knowing what the history that we created today.
Yeah.
From getting up at, you know, me and Yafel were working on some other stuff around 4 in the morning. But by the time we got to you, it was about 6 this morning, 6:30 in the morning. And then going to Gorilla Cafe and picking up some of the pastries and just the community effort that it, you know, people, and just seeing people that you never met before.
Just showed up.
Just showing
they
up
showed
to the
up.
Garden.
They were there.
And just there with their own tools and excited from all generations and of all shades and, you know, so I'm still feeling good. And then to leave that event and then go and do, you know,
Urban Relief and Common Vision.
Yeah, and then me and having Michael here in town. And so, but I just wanted to just say something about, you know, Dr. King. And I remember really one of my first I it was a personal connection with him on his birthday. I decided to just read one of his books. Mm. And it was To Strive Towards Freedom, which was the first book that he wrote.
Freedom.
Yes. And then after reading that book, I really felt that while we tend to say his name.
And the dream speech.
And his dream speech.
That's it.
We really need to look a lot closer into his vision. Because
yes.
He shared a lot of information. I mean, and then after that, where do we go from here? Chaos, Our Community, which is another powerful book that he wrote.
Mm-hmm.
And just really, if you have the time today, just pick up some of his works and, you know, read for yourself the kind of vision that he had. Mm-hmm. I mean, he had this thing called the educational park, where why do we have schools with walls on them?
Oh, my
God. Why don't
we
just take the school outdoors? And I can just see how with all of our tree planting and gardens.
Yeah, and that's what we want to do.
You know, what we want to do. And he was just saying that there's so much, like, all this these problems with segregation, et cetera, during those days, of course. But I think we're getting to that place
where we could we can envision a school that's outdoors,
that's
the garden.
Exactly.
The garden school.
That's
okay.
Right.
Oh,
that's
my God.
Right.
That sounds
that's
exciting.
That's right. It's very exciting.
Yeah, let's do it today.
Let's do it. Let's do it. And we did.
Because
we were teaching, because people were coming with different resources. You know, we're coming with just sharing what they do.
We had shovels out there. We had people bringing their tools and their love and their spirit. The sun was beautiful and perfect.
That's
it was
right.
A beautiful, beautiful day, which we will repeat. It's
and
not
the principal,
be one time.
Brother Abdul, the principal
from
Yosa, was there with his whole family.
It was wonderful.
And just opened it all up for us. And we want to just keep it going.
Right. So, and you did.
And
so
did.
Then y'all left.
Yes.
I took a break and came to the radio station to prepare for this. But you guys went on to, what was the name of the girl?
Urban Relief.
Urban Relief.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
We're planting trees all up and down Martin Luther King Way. And let's just talk about Martin Luther King Way in every city in
this
country.
That's right. Yes.
Let's talk about Martin Luther King Way, especially here in Berkeley, Oakland.
That's
I think
right.
It's important. It's a perfect example. From one end of MLK to the other is light years difference.
That's right.
In terms of property ownership, beautification, what the value of the real estate is, you know, all of that. If we look at the spectrum, particularly here, and I'm sure it's everywhere, in Michigan, I know there's a Martin Luther King. In Chicago,
that's
I know there's
right.
a Martin Luther King. We need to look at how that real estate is owned, used, farmed, gardened, or not.
That's right.
And how it's let go and who owns it and reclaim it back. So I love the idea that we plant trees under the freeway overpass.
Right.
And okay, so we hooked up with Michael Flynn, or you guys did, brought him with you.
That's
Tell
right.
us, Michael, some good news. What was going on today for you with Common Vision?
Some good news. Common Vision is right now in the we're getting ready for our 6th annual fruit tree tour.
Ooh.
And this is a project that we've been doing now for a while. Every year, 25 volunteers from Common Vision hop aboard a fleet of vegetable oil powered school buses, and we go through the cities of California, and we don't stop until we plant 1,000 fruit trees with schools and community centers across the state.
Excellent.
And that's how we've had the blessing of meeting Anna Marie Carter and David Roach.
Yes.
We've been working with communities all about and just trying to help students to connect with their neighborhoods as a place of beauty, abundance, reconnecting with their food sources, tasting fruit that's much sweeter than anything they've ever had from the store.
For real.
And just trying to support the health and inspiration of communities that we get the privilege of getting to spend time with. And one of our big focuses at Common Vision is bringing in the arts. We bring in drumming, dancing. We encourage the students to write rhymes about how they want to see change in their community, and we help them put it to music on instruments made out of recycled urban trash.
Oh, right.
Wow. And in this way, the kids start to build the movement from their own sense of what they want to see change.
Right.
And the kids all have the same vision. They want to see less violence. Mm-hmm. They want to see more love, more abundance, more, you know, when they're really pressed, more access to food, you know, more access to
money, to cash.
Exactly.
Can we bring that up?
Yeah,
now this is what I love. When we come, this is how the universe provides for us, because David and I were talking earlier about how we could use the garden this before. He told me about Martin Luther King's vision of the Wallace classroom,
yes,
but how we could use the garden to teach people how to read.
Yes.
Because this is the
mm-hmm.
one thing that we're lacking, I think,
mm-hmm.
as a community. We've gotten out of the process that used to be commonplace of every family at some time or another was teaching someone how to read. Someone was going mm-hmm. out and learning how to read and coming back and teaching people how to read. We need to get back into
That's
it.
Right.
We need to get back into it. Rapping is good. Don't get me wrong. And I love my kids to rap, but they can't rap in my class unless they can write it.
There you
they
go.
Can't write it, mm. they can't rap it. That's just the way it goes. We need that.
And we need the space for that.
We do need it. And the gardens
yes.
are a great space, right?
That's right.
Yes.
I love reading in the garden, so I'm excited. I'm so jazzed. Can y'all tell?
Absolutely.
We got a quiet revolution going on. It's not so quiet no more.
Yeah.
That has been going on for about 15, 20 years now.
Mm-hmm.
Really, I want to give credit to the hippies, if I may,
yes.
in terms of love as a value, coming back culturally, people being able to say, I love and care about loving the earth. I care about loving my neighbor.
That's right.
You know, and I want to yeah. help people. I want to feed people. I don't want no more war. You know, and this is not the first time, of course. We have to remember we're part of a continuum. Somebody else somewhere said, I don't want no more war. And I want love. But we want to keep that going. I'm so excited today that there was a manifestation of that idea.
Yes.
Take a deep breath.
All right.
All right, I'm going to let y'all talk again for a minute, but I want to get the phone number out there in case you want to join us. We're going to give out some shout-outs if you like. You can call in and give shout-outs to people you love and miss, people you're not with right now, people who have inspired you, whatever you want. Share it, as long as it's an affirmation, something positive, at 1-800-958-9008. Or if you're in the 510 area code, 510-848-4425. Again, you can call in and talk about your ancestors, any good news you have. Tell us about what you might have done today to contribute to the building of our communities. Any child you loved and shared and learned something from today, anything you want, call us. 1-800-958-9008 or 510-848-4425. Now, let's go back to the day. I want to go back to this brother, to Yafeo.
Yafeo.
Yafeo. Yafeo. I'm just so, my yeah. English tongue is unforgivable, but you will forgive me. I'll get yes. it right before the end of the show, I promise. You had your music blasting
yes.
out at the site today. Talk about what was going on today with the music and the vibe and all.
Well, I had Stevie Wonder's first album.
Yes.
We featured that
Songs
first.
Songs in the Key of Life.
Yeah, Key of Life. And to me, it kind of just embodied the whole feeling of the day and the spirit that everybody kind of took to the garden. Everybody, I received everybody this morning initially because, mm-hmm. you know, Dave had a couple of runs. He had
right.
to go get
up.
Some of, you know, the dignitaries that were working with us.
Yeah,
and,
that's right. That's right.
As I accommodated the people coming, just the spirit was just, what could we do? It was so efficient. It was like, it was God's sin. It was God's work. It was, you didn't have to really tell. They just wanted to know what the mission was, and everybody went to it. And it efficiently just detailed itself and worked its way out. It was truly a work of God, and it seemed like it was hard to believe that we did so much work that efficiently so quickly without real
yes.
coordination
I know.
Or previous.
Just jumped in there.
And Joy was wow. like going around. I think we should move this over here. Like, what do we should do? Well, this goes over here, and it worked as if we,
yeah.
you know, had
coordinated.
This
yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah. It was.
Well,
fun.
We did. We planned to love that space today, and
uh-huh.
we did it in a loving, kind way. And I was very proud of
yeah,
all of you, being
so,
proud
yeah,
to be part of
so,
it.
Yeah.
So we're gonna take a little quick music break and take some phone calls. Okay, everybody, can catch their breath and get a little water. You're listening to About Health. This is KPFA 94.1. This is Joy Moore. Stay tuned. If you want to call us, 1-800-958-9008 or 510-848-4425. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
I am happy. I am happy. I have a dream.
I got a dream.
One day.
We're going to work it out.
One day.
We're going to work it out.
One day.
We're gonna work it out.
I have a dream.
I got a dream.
That one.
find this. Struggle is my address with pain and crack lips. Gunshots coming from sounds of blackness. Given this game with no time to practice. Born on the blacklist. Told I'm below average. A life with no cabbage. That's no money if you from where I'm from. Funny, I just want some of your son. Dark clouds seem to follow me. Alcohol that my pops swallow bottle me. No apology, I walk with a bold on my shoulder. It's the Cold War, I'm a colder soldier. Hold the same fight that made Martin Luther the king. I ain't using it for the right thing.
All right, getting a little bit of Common in there. Music video, Salute to the King. Yeah, we got all the good music around here. We know how to hip-hop it. I bet you Martin Luther King is hip-hopping to it, too. All right, you're listening to About Health. This is Joy Moore. I'm joined in the room by some wonderful dignitaries who are working out. I'm calling them solutionaries now because Anne-Marie gave us that. I was calling them advocates and activists, Obama's people, because Obama was a community activist, okay? Yeah. And the Obama people were out in the garden today,
That's
too.
Right.
I need to
That's
say
right.
that. Obama's
right.
people was out there yeah. in Castlemont with us.
And planting those trees. Too.
Yes. Right. So we got the Seed Lady from Watts, Anne-Marie Carter. She's doing great, wonderful things out there with the people in Watts and has been forever. David Roach, founder and the engine of Mo Better Foods. Yafeo of Culture
yeah,
and Freedom.
You said it right that
and
time.
Michael Flynn from Common Vision. And we're going to be joined by you. You can call us at 1-800-958-9008. Or 510-848-4425. We have a caller on the line from D.C. Talking about electronic hookup. Kathy, welcome to About Health. Is this my sister?
You know it. You know
all right.
I'm so proud of you, and I want to give out a shout to our uncle, Willie Stallworth, who did march with Malcolm X. I mean,
Martin Luther King.
I'm sorry. And that inspired us to come here and be with Obama.
Okay.
And because of my sister Joyce, we all eat healthy,
yeah, right.
and we think healthy, and we do healthy things, and we help and eat better and raise our kids better because of my sister Joyce. I'm so proud of her. I just admire her, and I'm just happy for her. And thank you for having this show. And, yeah, we're here in D.C. with all our family, and we're all going to see Obama.
Okay, at the Obama-thon. It's like, oh, my God, like spectacular yeah. adventurism or something, history-making.
You know, when we're there in the moment,
yeah.
we don't even think about the weather. You know,
yeah.
we're thinking
yeah.
about this historical moment.
Yeah.
And since our uncle would tell us what he did with Martin Luther King, now I could tell my granddaughters, you know, I was there with Obama.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. And we put Obama there. That's the other thing that I got today. We got to remember that.
That's right.
You know, Obama was the voice, the megaphone, but we're the ones, we're the wind behind his back. We got to keep that going. Y'all being there representing, that's a really good thing. Kiss my aunt, everybody, for me.
Yeah, they all excited.
Okay.
Yeah, shout out. They was all hollering. We all sitting around the computer.
Did I get everybody?
Yeah.
All right, I love you.
All right, yeah, the Russell family.
Okay, the Russell family. Y'all take care out there.
All right.
All right.
See you soon. I love you.
I love you, too.
Bye.
All right, this is what it's all about, y'all. Community. The stepping stones of community. What are the building blocks of community? Family.
Family.
Man, I'm tight with my family sometimes. Not always. But they support me. Okay, let's take another call. Kim from Richmond. Welcome to About Health.
Hey, good afternoon. Good afternoon, all you beautiful, lovely people over there.
Thanks. Oh,
thank
Hi.
You.
Thanks
thank
for
you.
Calling in.
Hey, thank you. Thank you. Thank you for putting this show on. I am remorse to say that this is my first time hearing this show. I had a note saying About Health, KPFA, but this is actually my first time ever hearing the show.
Wow.
And I'm so fortunate that you guys are talking about beautiful black things on today. It's truly, truly, truly a beautiful black day. But here's why I am calling. I am calling because I don't know if any of you sitting in the room have ever heard of, and first to give homage to the ancestors and all those out and doing things. I don't know if you've ever heard of critical mass health conductance.
Yes,
absolutely.
Yes, we heard that. Yeah. I love it. And there was tell me if I'm wrong about this. It was like a matching of history and people with who needed help with their health care.
Well, you know what? That very well could be some of it. But when I am talking about critical mass health conductors, speaking of ancestors, health conductor number one is Harriet Tubman.
Harriet Tubman, yes, absolutely.
Okay. And the reason Harriet Tubman is health conductor number one is because she had the vision, the foresight, the strength, the passion, and everything else that it takes to move people to freedom.
Yes.
And today, our freedom is our health, is our health, is our health.
Yeah.
So Critical Mass Health Conductors is an opportunity for African Americans, black folks to get together in a room with people that look like them, that care about them, to promote better health conditions, i.e. freedom, through good health practices.
Yes, absolutely. Good healthy mind, good healthy body. You're right.
Healthy mind, healthy body, healthy spirit.
Yes.
Everything.
Absolutely.
And we start with ourselves.
Yeah.
So we have to identify something within ourselves that we feel that we need to work on as a health issue. And after we have worked on ourselves, then we have a charge on ourselves to go out and just like you all were doing it today,
yes,
taking it to the community and going out and doing it within the community. That's what we do as health conductors. We go out and we put it out in the community, and we help other people understand that health is a thing that's attained to help us become free.
Right.
And we have to realize.
We're realizing it today, aren't we, together? You calling and telling us, reminding
us
that's how it is.
You know what? Yeah. I appreciate us realizing it. And if we all realized it, we really wouldn't need to be out there jumping up and down and doing all this stuff. So we do really need to realize. And I know sometimes we preach to the choir, and I'm not trying to preach to the choir, but if anybody out there is interested, and I hope you all will, think about, and being a part of Critical Mass Health Conductors. Just as a shout out, there's a gathering and a cycle and a journey starting on February coming to the Health Summit on February 6th and 7th. Yes. And that's going to be at the Marriott down there in downtown Oakland.
Okay.
And it's free.
Okay.
It's free on Saturday, and you come on down there, and you can learn about the health and have fun finding out about health and further and learn more about Critical Mass Health Conductors.
Thank you.
Thank you, Kim.
On our way to freedom.
This is great. See, this is what I was saying before about folks, how much stuff is going on, right? We're all part of a one thing, the earth. Did I say that before?
Good thing.
So not only are we all part of one thing, I figured out today, I think we talked about this earlier, why we're here.
That's right.
Yeah, Homer and all these people trying to figure out what's the point of living. Why
Joy
are we here?
Came up with the
why
reason.
Did they put
Joy
us
knows.
Here? I mean, why am I suffering?
That's
I need some CDs. I need some iPods. Why did you have me? Don't have we all asked our parents?
Yes.
Why did you give birth to me? and leave and treat me like this.
Yeah. Right.
But I figured it out. We are here to eat.
That's right. Mm.
We are here to eat. They changed it on, switched around on us. We were supposed to eat to live.
Yeah.
No. We are supposed to live to eat.
This is
why we're here. We are not only are we here to eat, we are here to make more people so that they can eat too.
That's right.
Everything else is extra.
Right.
Can you talk about it?
Right.
Where you live, where you cook it, how much it costs,
that's
who you eat it with, what kind of music you drink, what you drink with it.
Yeah.
All you know, the essential thing is we're supposed to eat.
That's right.
Everything.
That's right.
I don't think there's any question. Anybody can disagree with that. Okay, now that's how to solve all of our problems.
There you go.
We don't know why. We didn't know why we were here. Now we know why.
That's way deeper than what Homer was talking about.
I ain't talking about chubby and fat and out of health. You know what I'm saying? Eating properly, eating the right way, and going out and growing your own food so you can't get fat.
That's right.
Because you got to get out and get that hoe out, get that rake out, get that shovel out, get down and weed.
Yeah.
Then you'll use those calories so you'll grow some more food so you can
eat. And reproduce.
So
you know,
can eat.
But I just want to just comment on that last caller, because to have Harriet Tubman.
Yes.
As the one of our ancestors,
as a
major ancestor, the number one. I mean, just to be able to, as she said in this call, get yourself together.
Yeah.
But Harriet kept going back and getting more
other people. That's right. That's
her,
what we don't
and
have.
And put her life
of.
On the line.
Yes.
Every
hundreds
of times.
Yes. Absolutely. She did.
Had to take
she
the
did.
Trip by herself the first time. Her husband and her dad wouldn't go. Brother wouldn't go.
Yeah. That's
came back and her husband had another wife, and she was a real soldier.
Yeah, we need to look up Harriet Tubman and read some of that stuff,
bad.
Too. She was a wonderful woman. I actually had the the pleasure of playing her voice in a film called Mean to Be Free when I was in college a long time ago. Okay, let's take another call. Ali from Fresno, you're welcome to About Health.
Peace and love to all.
Greetings
to you.
Thank you.
I'm calling from Fresno, and I'd like to report the Golden West Side Farmers Market, who we have put together, and we'll be moving into the Allensworth community next month.
Oh, beautiful.
And, congratulations.
And thank you. And we also have a Allensworth corporation who currently has 58 acres and growing wheat at the moment.
Wow.
And so we're hooking up with those folks, and we will be coming to both the north and the south end of the state and doing some real good things. We found that there's treasure of darkness in hidden places, and we seem to think Allensworth is one of the hidden places.
Oh, yes, definitely.
Currently, we have, shout out to the ancestors, we have 44 ancestors in the cemetery, a five-acre cemetery in the town of Allensworth.
Right.
And we nominated the Allensworth to the National Historic Trust. Hopefully we can get some support there. Hopefully Michelle Obama would hear that. We got some folks in New Orleans, Washington, D.C. as we speak, and they're going to the archives and see how many Buffalo soldiers we have in the cemetery. So we're actually calling to let folks know we're rocking here in the Central Valley.
All right.
And David Roach, you know me. We met some time back.
Oh, yes.
African-American farmer.
Yes. Yeah.
And so we have a number of farmers in there, and we have thousands of acres in the Central Valley. So we're putting that together. We're teaming up and coming and getting to that oneness that we need to be in the community. So
that is so good. Allensworth, you know you got to tell us, just to take a minute because there's lots of people out there who don't know Allensworth.
That's
just because you
popped
that out that's information.
Right.
Can you take just a minute, brother, and tell us about it?
Yes. Well, Allensworth was founded and financed in 1908. It was incorporated in 1908, and Colonel Allensworth and four other gentlemen who actually was on point with the vision and went out to Central California. Allensworth is located in Tulare County, actually on Highway 43. Get about 80,000 people out there a year just to go visit the state park. The state park consists of about 242 acres. But that's just one part of the 800 acres that was purchased by our ancestors. 800 acres.
Wow. Can you imagine that?
Yeah. As a result, in my opinion, we need to go back, reclaim, and with this new 100 year, we just celebrated the 100 year, and I believe it was.
Okay.
So we need to, some of us see fitting that we're involved. We're actually in the trenches, and we're doing some good things there with artists and so forth, so on, to hook up with us and be able to make this happen in the state of California.
Thank you so much for calling in to tell us that good news. Go ahead, Dave.
I just want you to let's get reconnected because it's been quite a while.
Yeah.
So if you could, I mean, we're gonna get our contact information.
Yeah, we're gonna get contact information. And if you want to share, brother, if some people want to get with you and celebrate the establishment of Allensworth and the rejuvenation of it, because I've seen there's some stuff coming up. We saw you on California Gold and on PBS. They've been doing some specials on Allensworth. So I know when that happens, that means somebody paying attention.
Yes.
So tell us how we can contact you if you want to get more involved.
Yes, currently we have a website going up. There's a few things that there's a group throughout the United States. We got some folks in New York, in Chicago, Detroit, South Carolina, Tennessee, Atlanta, et cetera. So I will stay in touch, give you that website when at the completion of it. And in addition to that, we're going to celebrate the Colonel's birthday in April. April 4th, 5th, 6th, and 7th. On the 7th of April, 2009, we will be celebrating the Colonel's Earth Day, which has never been celebrated.
Wow.
And we're going to do that in Fresno.
Okay.
The Holiday Inn, we'll keep you updated on that.
Okay, good.
And we're going to have a number of events. One event, we're going up to the Sequoias, visit those who know about sweating. We have some of the
sweat lodges, huh?
Yes.
All right.
And we're going back, and when we come down, we're going to be fired up. And we're going to tour Allen's Worth, give a tour of the entire 800 acres, and there's a number of opportunities there. So
okay.
ancestors did that for us. We need to take it to the next millennium.
Absolutely. This is what I'm loving, celebrating farmers, celebrating homesteaders, people who planted the land, cultivated the land, tamed it, brought some food out, shared it. This is what we're about. This is what we're here for.
That's right.
And we have forgotten that because we got so many mechanical, electronical, gasoline pull kind of things going on that we didn't forget what the real deal is about. So I'm here. This is About Health. I am in the studio with Anne-Marie Carter, the Sea Lady of Watts. She's got some serious things going on, helping us get the CO2 out of the air. We're going to get her contact information. Everybody's at the end. David Roach, founder, and I call him the engine of Mo Better Foods, Mandela Markets, among other things. And we have Yafeo from Culture Freedom. I'm not going to try to say your last name, brother.
Tiamba.
I'm going to get that, too, now before we leave here. And also Michael Flynn from Common Vision. So we're going to take some more calls. You can join us if you'd like to get into the conversation. You can give a shout-out to your ancestors. Tell us about some good news or whatever positive thing you want to, a positive tip or information you want to share with us today. 1-800-958-9008 or 510-848-4425. Let's see if we got another caller on the line.
Well, you know, that was really, by you getting this other caller,
yeah,
that was just about April the 4th.
Yeah, we got the April 4th through 7th at the Fresno Holiday Inn.
Yes.
This is a beautiful thing.
Yeah, people don't know about this land
that
the water supply was cut off.
Right.
It was a whole.
How they got it.
That's how
they took
got it.
They cut them off from the water. And in fact, they even agreed that they could keep the water rights.
Yeah.
And then they changed their mind later on.
Yes.
So we know there's a history. And this is the other thing that goes back to what a lot of the teachers and the people that I work with, the European people who are teaching our children in the public schools. A lot of times they say, oh, well, you know, we do try to do history and we do Martin Luther King and we do Sojourner Truth and meet a couple people,
right,
but they don't talk about Allen's Worth, you know.
Right.
They don't talk about Rosewood, you know. And so a lot of people say, well, how come the African people don't just get up and, you know, they're so lazy and they could have done this and why didn't they? Well, we have, and every time we try to make an attempt for self determination, for ownership, we're cut down, we're undercut, or we're abused.
Until last week. Until yesterday.
Now things are looking up, and then this is back to the hope thing.
That's right.
Hope is it springs eternal. Hope
yes,
springs
does.
Eternal, and without it, we know, without food and hope, I'm gonna revise that. What we need to live, we need hope and food, okay?
And reproduce,
and we need to. Oh, we're gonna reproduce. Nobody even gotta tell you that. You'll just reproduce naturally. Let's go to Lily. Welcome to About Health.
Yes, I'm from Fresno, also.
Oh, hi, Lily from Fresno. Welcome to About Health. Thanks for calling in.
Yes, I heard the gentleman speak about Allen's Worth, and I happened to be in Tulare County a couple of years back before I moved to Fresno when the Board of Supervisors was supposed to push through a farm from a local rancher in and around Allen's Worth, but the state of California spent millions of dollars buying the property around Allen's Worth. Many, many people, African-American people, black people from California, came in and fought the Board of Supervisors, and finally the rancher did concede to the state of California, but okay. it was a fight.
But
what I'm basically, and that's great, and I'm glad that they won that. But you know, you have to really, if you really want something, you really have to show and force that you mean business.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm really calling in because my daughter's biracial, of African American descent, and I have to tell you something. She has been ill for about 3 years. We've gone to numerous doctors, spent thousands of dollars, not being able to figure out what's wrong with her. Finally, I took her to an infectious specialist, and this was a gentleman of a Caucasian descent, and he took one look at my daughter, and he thought, well, high risk. She had a few tattoos, young. She probably had AIDS. I spent 2 weeks in abject misery thinking my daughter had AIDS. It turned out she didn't, but we're still looking for a solution as to what she has. And we're still going from doctor to doctor. And I just think that there is a bias against African-American women. And
really?
I didn't know it until, well, really.
we're glad you caught that.
Oh, boy.
And particularly you have a daughter. You have a daughter who has to deal with this. This is an issue, you know?
It's an issue that has really pushed me towards the brainy point of thinking, Well, you know, there is a certain mentality that goes along with doctors when they see a person of African American descent.
Yeah.
And it's put us in a kind of a corner because now we're having to start from zero again, and it's very costly to do that.
Yeah.
But I just thought, you know, I would mention that, and I know that it's probably not just African American women that are, exposed to that kind of discrimination.
No, women in general are not given a short shrift by the medical profession in this country. And let's just begin with the test that they do. When they test, the average tester is a male person.
Right.
It's a male, European descent. That's
right.
The average person. So, anyway, but I'm so glad you called in. But I do want to suggest looking at sickle cell. It was one of the things that we've forgotten about.
Mm-hmm.
Sickle cell is looked on here in this country as a bad thing. But sickle cell really is a mutation of our cells that allowed us to survive the plague and malaria, actually.
Right.
And so it protects us, but when it's in different climate, it has a different effect. So I just want you to look at that. I'm not saying that's what your daughter has.
Well, they think that she might have valley fever because, you know, she's lived, but it could be sickle cell.
I'm just saying, as an excuse, some of the things that we don't think about or we've forgotten about and certainly does not get enough attention, the maladies that African Americans face. One of them is stress. There's just not getting around to it.
Right.
Generations of stress.
Mm-hmm.
And that's still continuing, how that affects your health. But compounded with the fact that when you do go to the doctor, if you are lucky enough to have health care or health insurance of some kind, you're
mm-hmm.
not given the respect that you deserve when you're with the doctor. Any of us are. None of us are, really,
right.
to be honest. But specifically on the totem pole, we get the least amount of shrift.
Mm-hmm.
We have some hysteria or something mental going
right,
on.
Right,
it's never a physical
right.
thing. But Anne-Marie said she wanted to say something. Hold on.
Yes, hello. I wanted to just say this to you because when you first started talking and you said where you lived in Tulare County,
mm-hmm.
I wanted to, because I'm an environmentalist, I'm a scientist and a researcher, among other things, and I know one thing about that county. It has heavy metals in the air,
mm-hmm.
and also it could be your daughter's diet. So, may
right,
I,
right.
I'm not a doctor, and I'm not prescribing anything.
This is not a medical show.
This is not a medical show.
Well,
I am not prescribing anything to you, but I want to bring something to your attention.
Mm-hmm.
The fact that you live in one of the most polluted counties in
right,
California.
Right, right.
You probably need to get her blood tested
right,
for heavy metals.
Oh, I didn't think about that.
And then the second thing is that the quality of air and the level of pesticides in your
yes.
county is so high, it
mm-hmm.
would behoove you to get mm-hmm. her colon cleansed.
Mm-hmm.
Young people generally do not get their colon cleansed. Usually they have
right.
to come down with some life-threatening disease in
right.
order to clean their colon. But I pray and hope for your daughter's rapid recovery and health,
mm-hmm.
and I hope wholeheartedly that you hear my voice and hear my words and have your daughter take some type of colon cleanser and
mm-hmm.
see if that might turn the tide for her, and then also get her on an organic diet.
Yeah, as much as you can.
And I absolutely agree with you.
Absolutely.
She is heavy, and diabetes runs in the family, and
right.
she does have some other health issues. It could be a combination of
yes,
all.
Yes,
I believe
it. But I think when you look at somebody, sometimes you look at their nationality, and you're not looking beyond that. That was my main call. But thank you so much for the time. I appreciate
you're
it.
You're welcome.
No, thanks for calling in.
Thank you.
All right, let's hurry up and see if we can get another call. Barbara from Redwood City, welcome to About Health.
Oh, hi. My name is Barbara, and I'm from Redwood City. I just wanted to mention when the caller was talking about Allensworth, which is such an amazing historic place, that there is a documentary that was made about Allensworth, funded by PBS.
It was on PBS. We just mentioned it. Yes, thank you.
Oh, sorry, I didn't know.
No,
you
that's
didn't.
Okay. That's good. I can't. There's nothing new under the sun.
Yes, but I wanted people to know that they can look at the California State Parks website to watch that documentary.
Okay.
They don't
that's
have to wait for it to be on. They can go to the website for the California State Parks, and my ex-husband wrote the script, and it's a really great
story. Oh,
wow.
Excellent.
So it really is an amazing story, and I just wanted to mention that. So thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Okay,
thank you. All right, you are listening to About Health. We were just speaking with Barbara. We're joined in the studio by Anne-Marie Carter, Sea Lady of Watts, David Roach, founder of Mobetta Foods, Yafeo of Culture Freedom, and Michael Flynn from Common Vision. I'm going to work on that last name. And this is Joy Moore. Dr. Lenore will be back next week. So we're doing shout-outs. If you want to shout-out to an ancestor, I would like to shout-out to my ancestors who passed, my grandparents, very important to me, both sets, Laika Muhammad and Eswali Muhammad and Paul Moore, Sr. and Ruby Moore, who was my grandmother. They've passed. They're my ancestors. They guide me. I think about them often. I try to remember always that they're there. I try to remember that my grandmom is looking down at me when I'm in my room doing something I'm not supposed to do. And it kind of keeps me on track. So if you want to join us, you can call 1-800-958-9008 or 510-848-4425. Let's take another call. Let's go to Luann in San Francisco. Welcome to About Health, and thanks for your patience.
Oh, thank you so much for your show. Blessings to all of our ancestors and to all of your work. I work in the criminal justice system, and my question to Mobetta Foods and Better Vision do you have any suggestions or ideas about how we can take the commissary out of the incredible system that it's within right now? It's terribly overpriced. It's really, really bad, unhealthy, salty, fat, crappy food, and it's like triple times the price. And I was wondering if you would have any suggestions on, you know, organizations or any other agencies that might be interested in working really hard to take that commissary over. And I'll take your answer off the air. Thank you so much for your work.
Oh, thank you. I would just say that that's the idea, is to grow your own food and to create the business that most of these communities that we have don't really have a business community. And so a lot of our youth that are incarcerated are not being educated to become more self-sufficient. And I would love to figure out, we have some people that are working in San Francisco, but to better answer your question, not all the answers now, but I would love to talk with you further, and if you could contact us at Mo' Better Food.
And we'll give out contact in just a second.
Definitely. Mm-hmm.
All right.
Yes. And Michael.
And Michael?
Yes.
Yeah. Whatever we can do to help inspire our inspire the youth of today to connect with growing their own food, so that real drive is there for organizing communities around taking care of our health and taking our food needs into our own hands.
Yes.
Okay, thank you for that call, Luann. Let's move on. Let's do Tom in Oakland. Welcome to About Health.
Yes, ma'am.
Hi, Tom.
In reference to the woman who called about the sick black child,
yes,
you might want to check on the melanin reports and the melanin research that has been done, especially by Dr. Richard King out of San Francisco State.
Okay.
And you will study, well, there's a lot of, I'm not going to go into it over the phone, but there's a lot of research being done, and it may answer some questions of why you might be having problems with Caucasian doctors and
right.
certain biological and genetic
right.
differences between melanated people and,
yeah.
shall we say, less melanated
yeah,
people.
Yeah, it's high melanin and low melanin, because we all have melanin, so that's important. But I got you. So
right, and also I'd be interested if you can get Dr. Richard King on your show.
Okay, that's a good idea.
And Raphael.
Yafeo, Uncle Tom, what's up, man?
Y'all must know each other out here, Chinese name.
What did you think about that Qigong DVD that I gave you?
It's off the chain.
Okay.
I'm
going to
use it with some children I'm working with.
And Dave.
Yes, sir.
Don't call me sir. I work for a living.
Oh, my
you
goodness.
You never told me you had access to thousands and thousands of black farm acreage in the Central Valley.
I never told you?
Do you?
I'll see when you guys are opening up the market for the spring session.
Oh, we're going to get back in either May or June. Right now, we're working on these gardens and trying to find the 1,000 acres you said. Well, I'm looking forward to finding that myself, but I will.
So that's some good news for you.
Thank you.
We got the Mandela market to look forward to in June.
Yeah.
All right, let's try to get one more call. Oh, no, we don't have another call. My engineer, Mickey, is saying to us. Okay, so let's just move on this. So you can call us. We've got a couple more minutes. 1-800-958-9008 or 510-848-4425. I'd like to ask all of you to do a little shout-out for your ancestors. Let us know a little bit about who you're missing, who loved, where you came from, where you sprung from, you know, who inspires you, whatever you'd like to say. Let's start with Anne-Marie.
I would love to shout out to all my grandmothers. I usually people only have one or two grandmothers. I had like three or four. It's a long story. We won't talk about it here. But there was Big Mama, there was Little Mama, there was Grandma, and then there was Grandmother. Mm-hmm. So between the four, I was taught how to grow organic food, how to cook organic food, how to plant organic seeds, how to raise babies, how to keep a house clean, how to bake bread. They taught me a combination of life skills. And I think that the women have a responsibility to start taking time out, turning those TVs off, and taking your children in the kitchen and start teaching them some culinary arts and go in the backyard. I grow gardens. I've grown over 5,000 gardens in my day. And let me tell you something. I have grown gardens on concrete, on roofs, in alleys, on the side of houses. There is no excuse. In a container, in a pot, if you name it, you can grow it. And you need to teach the babies how to do it, because that is our future. Our children are our future. And I'm so blessed to have had those four ladies know that I was their future, and to instill in me the pride of being a woman and being organic and being black and being on this planet. I'm also Indian, so being Indian too. So being on this planet to learn how to save seeds, sprout seeds, give seeds away, and be a seed.
All right. Thank you, Anne-Marie. I love you. You know it. I love you. All right. Let's go to Brother Yafeo Tiambe.
Yes. I would like to give thanks to my siblings. I'm the baby of eight, and eight's been a very intricate number in my life.
Eight.
I was the eighth month. I was the eighth child. I graduated in 86. My birthday, I was born in 68.
So eight's a big number for you.
So just to my siblings, I want to start and give shout-outs to my brothers, but to my ancestors, two of them, that my sister Bernadette Nelson and my sister George, fastest handshake in the West, who, you know, passed because of AIDS. And my sister, who just had a mishap. And they were very impactful in my life as far as my appreciation for music and for accepting other cultures and other people's lifestyles or whatever, just accepting people and being open.
All right.
You know.
Thank you for that.
Thank you.
All right, a little quick, because we'll still get contact information out. Michael?
Yeah, I want to give a shout out to my mom, who passed away of cancer when I was in high school.
Ashe.
And, you know, I just had this sense right from early after she passed that it was something to do with how we were living that was causing that cancer.
True.
Something that she was never told about, that we were never told about. And that's the fire under my behind me every day to help people make some organic choices right now.
Yes.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for your work. All right, David.
Yes, I would like to give a shout out to Hillary Bennett, who was my stepfather. And who passed away also of cancer, and helped raise, you know, us five boys, and to become educated and to, you know, be who we are.
Teachers.
You know, to be teachers.
Yes.
To keep learning.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Yes.
All right, really good. So this is about health. We are going to take contact information. We got 1 minute, y'all. We cut this really close.
Okay.
1 minute, we'll start with Anne-Marie Carter, Seed Lady Watts, contact information.
TheSeedLady@Hotmail.com.
All right. And Yafeo from Culture Freedom?
CultureFreedom1@gmail.com. That's culture with a K.
All right. And Michael Flynn from Common Vision.
You can just check us out at www.commonvision.org.
Oh, this is so simple and beautiful. I love it. David.
Right. Mo Better Food. M-O Better, B-E-T-T-E-R, food.com.
And always here, you can contact us at abouthealth@KPFA. This is Joy Moore. We have been talking about good things today. We've invoked our ancestors, remind our ancestors that we remember them. We expressed our love for our community today. We went out and shared ourselves with the students in the community out of Castlemont. We had you guys call in. Thank everybody who called in and shared with us. And we had good news show today. A good news show
good
today.
News.
A good news show
good
today.
Good
what does that mean? There? It's good
That's
news
good
out
news.
There. Everything's
news.
Not bad. Remember that. Take care of yourself. Keep your health. You don't have anything, any greater asset than your health. And Dr. Laura will be back next week. I want to thank Miss M for engineering, as always, giving us the confidence and inspiration that
everywhere.
We need, a technical skill. And Happy New Year, everybody. Love you, Obama.
Jay, Mama, I love you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Let's go back. It's April 1949. You turn on your radio. The tubes slowly warm up, and the sounds of KPFA come through the mono speaker. A little static, but listenable, with news, music, and arts. That was KPFA then. This is KPFA now.
This is Amy Allison from The Morning
Show.
This
is Dave McBurney from Music of the World.
This is Hard Knock Radio. I'm Anita Johnson.
My name is Kutai Derenkwai from Music
of
the World.
I'm Lim Lavijo, KPFA Interim General Manager.
KPFA on your digital stereo, your iPod, your BlackBerry, your computer. KPFA now. Available whenever and wherever you are each day of the year. News, music.